Now we go over to the story of coal. What is the story of coal? What can you say about the story of coal? About 300 million years ago, means I'm talking about many, many years back, the earth at that time was covered only with some dense forests and low-lying areas, marshy areas, wet areas, wetland areas, and all were there. So due to some natural processes, something might have happened at that time, floods came or some fires came. Because of that, the forests got completely damaged and they got buried under the soil. More and more soil was deposited over them. As a result, they got compressed. You understood, no? What is the meaning of the word? Compressed means they get pressed. The temperature became very high and so they became deeper and deeper. They got suppressed more and more. Because of high pressure and high temperature, all the plants that were dead slowly converted into coal. Now, children, when I told you the story, it does not mean that the coal making process took place in 1 year or 2 years or 3 years or 4 years. No, it took a long, long, long time for this process to get completed. It happened many, many years back. Many, many forests got pressed or got damaged, got compressed. Because of high temperature and high pressure, the plants that were there dug deep into the soil, they converted into coal. That process took place in many, many years. So it was not an easy process. You can see on the slide a coal mine. This is how a coal mine looks. You can see that a mine is always there. They are just going on taking it from the deeper layer of the earth's crust. Extraction of coal is going on. It is a very tough process. Many, many people are working in the coal mines. Now let us see, what does coal consist of? Coal mainly contains carbon. You know, carbon is a most abundant element in the nature. So coal contains mainly carbon. And the slow process, I told you the process is very slow. The slow process of conversion of dead plants or vegetation into coal is called carbonization. And because it is formed from the remains of the plants, coal is called a fossil fuel. And when heated in air, coal burns, you know, because oxygen is there in the air. So coal combines with oxygen and produces carbon dioxide gas because carbon is present in the coal. And when it burns, it reacts with the oxygen in the air and it forms carbon dioxide gas. Is that clear? So what does coal contain? The major constituent in the coal is carbon. And it is a very slow process, I told you. When the dead plants are being converted into coal, what is that process called? Carbonization. And because it is obtained from the remains of the plants or from vegetation, that is why it is called a fossil fuel. And when heated in air, what does it form? It reacts with the oxygen in the air and forms carbon dioxide gas. Now, what is done to that coal? Now, coal we are getting from nature. We are getting from the soil, or we are getting from the deep layers of the earth's crust. Are we using it like that only, in that form only? No. Some processes are taking place in the industry so that we can make some useful products out of them. The first product that is made from the coal that we are going to study about is coke. What is coke? Coke is also a tough and a black substance, but it is highly porous. Porous means what? It has got holes in it. It is porous. It is a pure form of carbon, but it is used in the manufacture of steel and in the steel industries, and also in the extraction of many, many metals, you know, metallurgical industries where metals are taken from their ore. In all these processes, coke is a very important constituent. I hope coke is clear. So what is coke? It is a process, it is a substance like coal. It is also black in color. It is a very tough substance, but it is porous. It has got the pure form. It is a pure form of carbon. It is used in the manufacture of steel and also in many other metallurgical industries. Now we go to another substance called coal tar. But with this word, you might be quite familiar. What is coal tar? You all know what is the tar. The roads that are there all around us, they are all covered with a black colored substance that is called tar. Some of you might have seen that tarring of roads going on also. It has got a very bad smell. you know, they go on heating it and then they spread it on the concrete roads. But what is this coal tar? It is also a black colored substance, but it is not a solid. It is a thick liquid and it has got a very unpleasant smell. It has got many, many substances in it. The products that are obtained from the coal tar are some dyes, you know, dye, synthetic dye that is used to make colors and all. Drugs are made by that. Certain explosives, perfumes, in the roofing materials, paint, etc. This coal tar is used for. Naphthalene balls, you know, with those small white balls which we put in our cupboards and all so that insects don't come inside the cupboard, they are called naphthalene balls. They are also obtained from the coal tar. So what is coal tar? It is a black colored substance, liquid it is, thick liquid. It has got a very bad smell. It has got many, many substances in it. The products obtained are some drugs are made with that, some dyes, explosives, perfumes, some roofing materials, paint, naphthalene balls, etc. are made with the help of this coal tar. Now we go to the next substance that is called the coal gas. What is coal gas? How is it obtained? When the coal that you learnt about in the beginning is processed and we get coke, that time a gas is released out that is called the coal gas. So coal gas is obtained during the processing of coal to get coke. In the factories and all, when the coal is used to make coke, at that time when gas comes out, that is called the coal gas. But that is also used as a fuel in many industries that are situated near the coal plants. Okay, so none of the things that you get out of the coal is wasted. Everything is being used up. Now we go to the next important resource, that is petroleum. What is petroleum? From the word petroleum itself, what comes to your mind? Yeah, petrol. What is petrol used as? It is used as a fuel. For what? In your automobiles, like motorcycles, scooters, cars, even trucks and tractors, and also they can use petrol also. But nowadays they are running on diesel. Heavy vehicles are running on diesel. So petrol and diesel are obtained from a natural resource called petroleum. So petrol and diesel combined, the word we use, that is petroleum. So what is petroleum? It consists of petrol also, diesel also. Petrol, you all know, it is used as a fuel for running our vehicles. And what is diesel? That is also used for running the vehicles like trucks and tractors, etc. So both these together constitute the petroleum.